हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम अगेन। एंड दिस इज माय न्यू प्रोजेक्ट, स्कूल मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम। एंड आई हैव डेवलप दिस प्रोजेक्ट इन PHP एंड माय एसक्यूएल। एंड द वर्जन आई एम यूजिंग इज द PHP वर्जन 7 एंड द माय एसक्यूएल वर्जन इज 5.6। सो एंड फॉर रनिंग दिस प्रोजेक्ट आई एम यूजिंग द XAMPP सर्वर। एंड करेंटली आई एम रनिंग दिस प्रोजेक्ट ऑन द विंडोज इन्वायरमेंट, बट इफ यू आर the VAMP server, then you can run this project also on the VAMP server. For Linux, you can run this project on the LAMP server, and if you are using the Mac, then you can install the MAMP server for running this project. So this is all about the backend technology and the server side. So for front-end technology, I am using the HTML, CSS and JavaScript and some of the jQuery library for giving some good effects, such as the integrating the date calendar and validations, as well as you are seeing, this is the animations which is running on the home page. So this is also a jQuery animation. Also I am using the jQuery plugin for creating the menus. Okay, so this is all about the front-end technology. So let's start with the functionality. So the project title is School Management System, and the technology I'm using the PHP MySQL, and currently I'm running this project on the XAMPP server. Okay, so this is the home page of the project. This is a totally static page, and there is no dynamic content on it. This is the about us page. So this is also a static page, and there is no dynamic content on it. The next one is a gallery. So this is the totally dynamic page, and all of the images are coming from the database, and the titles are also coming from the database. So the faculty means there are two types of roles available in the project, the admin and the faculty means the staff, and staff will be able to log inside the system and will be able to upload the images, and those images will be displayed here. And this is the staff. This is also the dynamic page, and all the staffs which has been added into the database will be displayed here. And the next one is the exams, and you can see this is the exam sections where you will be able to see the exams, all the exams which has been added from the admin. And there are these exams which has been added from the admin. And next one is the results. So this is the result section, but only the guardian who knows about the student ID and the semester which result is to be declared will be able to find out the result. Suppose so this is a select exam, so I am selecting the semester exam one, and the student ID is 7, and if I click on the submit, then I will be able to see the result of that student. So this is the result section. And attendance, and this is the student ID where you need to put the student ID, and if you click on the submit, then you will be able to see the attendance report of that student ID, and that student ID will be provided by admin. So this is the timetable of the exam, means on which date what the subject exam is going on and what is the date. So this is the time section, this is the day section, and this is the subject section and the timetable section. This is the login, and this is a role-based project. So from the single login page, admin and staff will be able to log in, but internal functionality will be changed according to the session. This is the contact us page, but this is a static page, and I am not saving the data of this static page anywhere in the database. Okay, so you can treat it as a static page. So now I am going to log in inside the system as an admin. So this is the admin functionality. So I am logging inside the project as an admin. Then what the admin can do? Admin can add a new admission, add a new staff, exams, and the class and the timetable, and he will be able to see the exam admission report, staff report, exam report, class report, and timetable report. Also, he will be able to change his account password in the logout section. Right, the same menu is available in the above menu section. then you can see in the administration all of the ad forms are available. So if you click on the admission, add admission, then you will be able to see the ad admission form, and this is the add new staff. Then the you will be able to add the new staff, and you will be able to assign a user ID and password of that staff. This is the add new exam, from where you will be able to add the new exam sections, and then the add new class, from where you will be able to add the new class. Then this is the add new timetable, so from where you will be able to select the exam. So this dropdown is totally dynamic, and all the exams which you added into a database will be rendered inside this dropdown, and the subject and the date. So this, you can see this is the jQuery plugin, and this is rendered because of I have indicated a date plugin inside the project, and this is the time and the description. This is the end timetable. So exam timetable, as I have already explained you. This is the report section. So there are 5 report sections inside the project. This is the admission report, from where you will be able to, Ms. Admin will be able to see all the student details, and he will be able to edit and update the details of the students, right? So this is the staff report, where admin will be able to see the, all of the staffs. So currently there are 3 staffs available, and he will be able to edit and delete the records of the staffs. This is the class report, from where admin will be able to see all of the classes which has been added earlier. And also, if he clicks on the student section, then he will be able to see all of the students of that class. This is a timetable report, where admin will be able to see the all of the timetables, including the time. So this is the you can see this is the semester 2 exams, and the subject is English, and the date is this one, and the time is this. So he will be able to edit or delete the record from here also. This is the change password, from where admin will be able to change his password details, and will, after changing the password, admin will be able to login inside the system with his changed password details. And this is the logout section. So once you log out from the system, then the above menu will be changed automatically, because this is a session driven menu. So now, as I told you earlier, this, there are 2 roles available inside the system, the admin and the faculty. Also, there is a parents role, but there is no need of the login for the parents role. Parents can search the things from here also. So I am logging as a staff. And what the staff can do? So you can see the staff dashboard has been changed. So staff can mark the attendance, add gallery, add the result, and will be able to see the attendance report, gallery report, a result report, student report, and the change password. So once you click on the mark attendance, then you need to choose the student first, and after that the date for which you want to mark the attendance. This is the add gallery, from where the staff will be able to add the gallery inside, add the photo inside the gallery, then title, occasion, and description, and the photo, and the add result section, from where the staff will be add the results of that students. This is the report section, from where staff will be able to add see the report of the students. So you can see this is the attendance report and gallery report. He will be able to edit and delete the record from here, and the result report, from where staff will be able to see the result of the students, and then the student report, from where staff will be able to see the attendance of the report, student of the report. And if he clicks on the attendance, then he will be rendered to the attendance part, where that student attendance will be rendered. And this is a change password, from where staff will be able to change his password, and the logout section. So this is all about the functionality. So this is the major project, and I have developed in the PHP and MySQL. And if you need more functionality in this project, just put it into the comment. I will incorporate those changes inside the project, and I will make this project more better and better. So don't forget to subscribe our channel for getting the latest video updates on the latest project technologies. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.